HarperCollins presents The Symmetry of Stars by Alex Myers, read by Kit Griffiths. The stars were creaking in the farthest sphere, shifting and arcing and drawing a dazzle of sparks across the rich dark of celestial space, tracing out the shape of a new age. It would dawn soon. And in that darkness, two immortal beings slumbered. Humans are always reaching for words to explain powers they cannot comprehend. Angels, archons, demigods, demons, muses. None of those words fit the beings that slumbered as the stars groaned. These two, bound together like magnetic poles, like sides of the same coin. Two beings invested with opposing forces, nature and nurture, forever linked to one another, forever at war. What they are is powerful, complex, eternal. The one stands for nature, the belief that everything is innate, settled, stamped in human flesh from the start. The other, nurture, the belief that all is potential, coiled within a fascinating yet frail body, that the true human self is coaxed out through love, training, and care. There is no tidy name for these beings, but names are important. Let them be called godlings. Prologue. It must have been the creaking that woke us up, woke me up. I'm not sure that the other one, nature, ever even sleeps. And I know they wouldn't have woken me up if I had somehow managed to sleep through all this grinding and groaning anyway. No, they would have let the new age dawn and set themselves as its ruler, allowing me to slumber through those crucial, crepuscular hours when all matters were determined, only to wake in the impossible glare of a morning that was entirely theirs. But luckily, I stirred before the stars had fully settled into their course, before the new age had been fully delivered. I woke, and in doing so, spoiled that other one's, my, though it pains me to put it so plainly, twin's plans. Here, in the space beyond, neither of us need be burdened by anything so mundane as a body. We exist in our truer forms, a shapeless shift of color, like the sheen of oil on water. My other, nature, stood gazing out at the stars, and just as sparks raced through the depths, so too did orange and red and yellow glare and flare across their form. I took this to mean they were excited. "Greetings, other," I said. It was nice to see them give a little jump. But their form had smoothed over, the reds and oranges muting to blue and gray by the time they turned and offered a reply. "Greetings, nurture. Welcome to this new age." Nurture is not my name. Nurture is simply what I am. What shapes me, and how, in turn, I shape the world around me. The sound of myself, nurture, emerged in my other's voice with a rasping, rotten taste. We really do not get along well. I stood and stretched and went to my other's side, the two of us peering over the deeps, which writhed and roiled out into the expanse of the farthest sphere, It has not yet arrived. The stars were still settling, bolts of fire now and then flaming out, sparks fizzling, and the creaking grated on as well. Even for us, it was an awesome sight. What sort of age will it be? Nature murmured, a question that had no proper answer, that spoke of potential and danger. It was difficult to stand so close to them. We are meant to be together, and yet meant to be opposed. It's not such a paradox. The world is full of such pairings. Whatever divinity or demonity created this universe must have loved polarity, dichotomy, duality. They loved, I'd say, twins. Some would say my other was my missing half, that we completed each other. Others would say that we negated each other, canceled one another out. I felt them strongly, repulsingly, every atom within me twisting away from them. But I also heard them, an echo of myself. Myself turned inside out, front to back. I fought to keep my form steady, a roil of calm, green, and blue. A new age, I equivocated, ripe to be ruled. I did not need to say, by me. My intentions were loud enough to be heard, or felt. It is my turn, they said. In the last age, we were both awake for. The rule was yours. They stared over the deeps, their form drawn in and concentrated, thick enough to look like smoke. Ah, yes, I said, sarcasm dripping from my every word. It was ordained to be my age, but you horned in and interfered just once, a dozen times. You couldn't keep your wretched, you were mangling things. I sought only to help. They pivoted, turning their attention from the deeps to me. A shiver ran through me, a vein of dark purple. Let us share this age, nurture, they said. We are siblings, after all. Share? Yes. I will take the left half of the world, and you take the right half, and away we shall go. I hunched together, gathering my substance, anticipating a long argument. Arguments with nature are always long. One might even say eternal. Firstly, my beloved other, the world does not have halves. It cannot be split like a melon. Second, even if we could divide it cleanly in half, you would still intrude. We know this about ourselves. We cannot share. We can do anything we want, they muttered. At least I can. We are in a state of bonded opposition, you idiot. We exist only because we are opposed to each other. I know, they sulked. I ignored their pouting, gray shape. We are two sides of the same coin. You can't crawl over onto my side, not without wrecking the coin. I paused. This metaphor, like most metaphors, was not exactly right. Forget the coin. We are like, you can forgo the comparison. I know what we are. We are twins. Their voice curled unpleasantly around the word. And like any siblings, we fight to differentiate ourselves. I am only myself because I am not like you. Exactly. So you cannot do anything you want. What you do will always be, in some way, linked to and shaped by your need to oppose me. That is how creation works. The power to create something from nothing, Yes, it comes from playing opposites against each other. They were still sulking, glooming over the edge, staring into the endless field of stars. What would you even do with this age, if you were to rule? They said at last. I relaxed a touch, let my substance spread out, washed through with green gold. Let nurture reign, I replied. Well, obviously, they snarked. My threads of green gold snapped back, flared orange. If I were to rule without your interference, I am nature. I do not interfere. I simply am, they insisted. It is you who nudges in and messes things up. Nurture, coddling and cooing and shaping and meddling. Nature, I scoffed, and I couldn't damp down the flickers of red that coursed through me. You ought to rename yourself neglect. I don't meddle, and I resent that implication. I simply open humans' minds to their full potential, allow them to see within themselves and others that they have the capacity to change and grow and develop. That's nurture, you idiot. Oh, good grief, be quiet. Who are you to tell me? We both fell silent as the stars gave a particularly loud groan. Who were we to be making such a scene before them? My other hunched closer, their words little more than a hiss. You're ridiculous. Humans don't care about capacity and potential. They care about hunger and thirst and power and, I cut them off, and what would your rule look like? They gave a shrug, if a formless thing can be said to give a shrug. I said it, so there, they gave a shrug. People are born. Some are strong and healthy and wise, and they succeed. Others perish or suffer. That's no kind of world. On the contrary, sibling, I'd say it's nature. Human nature, at least. They had a point. Humans could be rather brutal and simple-minded. In fact, if I had to be honest, which I don't, I would admit that if you left a group of human children entirely alone to raise themselves, the results would be much what my other had outlined, which is why nurture is so important. We will never settle this. We can't rule together. We would just cancel each other out. And we've proven that you can't be trusted to take turns and leave my age well enough alone. They bristled at this, a glisten of orange flares. I don't trust that you'd give me a turn after having taken yours. Very well. We can't share, and we can't take turns. So let's fight for it. Winner takes all. If I had eyes, I would have rolled them. In general, I prefer being unincorporated, but this is one significant drawback. We cannot fight each other, or rather, neither one of us can win in any decisive way. That's what it means to be in bonded opposition. Remember what I was saying about the coin, the sides thereof? I know, they whispered, and I could feel, like a deep, cold shiver, their resentment and hate. If they could get rid of me, they would, even if it meant getting rid of themselves. They shook their form like a dog in from the rain. Let us pick humans to be our proxies, I suggested. They sparkled a bit, gazed back out over the edge. Yes, find two humans, one for each of us. And let them bash each other bloody. If I had eyes.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.